It's the study of the impact of technology on human behavior. Our primary focus is internet psychology, but we also study virtual reality, artificial intelligence, intelligence amplification. The thing that we have to remember about the use of the internet is that it offers incredible access to content, the democratization of knowledge and information, a wonderful evolution in terms of education. But it also comes with risk. So I think certainly there are technical challenges, there are challenges in terms of filtering and screening content, and there are also educational challenges in terms of deciding what is appropriate for children at different ages. And I think that's a very important issue, especially when you talk about younger children. So we have, for younger children, we have Piaget's stages of development. What I would ask is, well, where are the cyber stages of development, the cyber cognitive stages of development? How do we recommend what is best at each age group? So, for example, one US study has pointed out that the average age at which a child gets a smartphone is age 6. Now, as a cyberpsychologist, I would argue that that is far too young. So really, from a policy point of view, we need to have developmental guidelines that could inform practice in terms of how children engage with technology at home, but also could inform best practice in terms of engaging with technology in school. The one thing that I really worry about is access to legal but age-inappropriate content. So specifically, that would be adult pornography, self-harm content, or extreme violence. When I'm talking to groups of children, I point out that what is seen cannot be unseen. There is no command delete file for the brain. If a child looks at a distressing or violent image or video clip, then it is almost impossible for them to get rid of that image from their brain. And that's why they need to be very careful about the sort of content that they expose themselves to. And schools have a very, very important role to play in advising children why they should not look at this content online and why it's a bad idea to engage with, you know, forums on self-harm sites or forums on or to engage in sites where extreme violent content is shown. The thing about cyberbullying is that real-world bullying is actually a problem because there's no evidence. A punch in the playground, a harsh word, that's very difficult to deal with. Cyberbullying is nothing but evidence. In fact, you cannot cyberbully without leaving a trail of evidence. The problem is that as a society, we've decided that any monitoring online is surveillance. But actually, when it comes to something like cyberbullying and minors, this is not surveillance. This is parenting. So effectively, I'm working on an algorithm that could be used to detect cyberbullying, could be offered by a telecommunications service provider, whereby the point at which the transaction triggers the algorithm, a digital outreach would go to the child to say, you need to get help, and a digital outreach would go to the parent to say, your child is in trouble, you need to go and talk to them. So effectively, the point is that the good news is that there are technology solutions to technology-facilitated problem behavior. We just need to have the will and the focus to pursue the solutions. If I had one piece of advice to parents, it would be that the point at which your child actually breaks a curfew or does something wrong and you want to punish them, please resist the urge to immediately confiscate all their technologies, take away their phone, take away their computer. Because the point at which your child is in trouble and they go to their room and they hate themselves and they hate the world and they hate you, if you have removed everything, you've also removed their entire support network. And you don't want to do that. Child needs to vent, they need to be able to talk to their friends, and this is how they do it. So pick a constructive punishment. Get them to mow the lawn or empty the dishwasher. but don't just take the opportunity to vent your frustration on their use of technology. That's not fair, and it's not smart.